Welcome to Nightline. I'm Gwen Hall, your host, and we are so glad that you've joined us on this Friday night. Yes, we're live, and our prayer partners are here, and I would love to hear some great praise reports. I know God is blessing you. I know there's one thing at least that God's done for you this week in particular. I want you to call. The number's on your screen right there. Call them up and tell them what the Lord has done for you this week. Amen. Crossfire, Randy Shepherd and Jamie Johnson are our special guests here tonight. We're going to have a time in the Lord. I'm going to start off with an old red book hymnal because I know you like them. Some glad morning we shall see Jesus in the air, coming after you and me, joys are to share. What rejoicing that will be when the saints shall rise, heading for that jubilee yonder in the sky. Oh, what singing, oh, what shouting on that happy morning when we all shall rise. Oh, what glory, hallelujah, near to meet our blessed Savior in the sky. When with all that heavenly host we began to sing, singing, what a day of shining on that happy morning. give you my best praise this night. Oh, yes, Father. You know this song. By the Walmart, by TV right now, just begin to praise him. He's worthy. Father, we enter your gates with thanksgiving, and into your courts we've come with our best praise this night to lift you up. We thank you ahead of time tonight for souls, for those, Lord, that's been in for so many months to be ministered to. It's all about you. You get all the praise and all the glory this night. In the name of Jesus, yes, amen, amen. At this time, I want us to go over to Wade, honey.
Isn't it good to be able to take time and to praise and give thanks unto the Lord? Do you know we're so blessed in so many ways? If we take the time just to look around, He's done so much for us that we can't praise Him enough. The Word says He's worthy of all our praise. And so we should take time each and every day to praise and exalt His name. And you can do that really all day long in how you perceive and project Him in your life to others that are around you. It makes a difference. So give Him praise, give Him thanks for all that He has done. Our prayer partners are here tonight. They come faithfully Monday through Friday to take your calls. If you've got a need, no matter what it is, you may be going through something spiritual, financial, it could be family problems, whatever it is, give us a call. Let us join our faith with yours, lifting that need up before the Father. And Gwen loves those praise reports, you know that. So if God's done something for you and you want to give Him praise for it, call that praise report in. Because what He did for you, there may be someone out there tonight that's going through the very same thing that you've gone through. And this will help encourage them, because what He did for you, it'll show them that He can do it for them also. Gwen, He's no respecter of person.
He's the same yesterday,
today, and forevermore.
Amen, amen. I love it when we can start this service off always praising Him and thanking Him. It's not about what I'm hitting some wrong notes, that's all right. But you know what it is? It's about giving Him praise from the heart.
That's it.
You know,
Wade will tell you he's not the best singer, even in the shower. But you know, he's gotten better. He really has. We go up and down the mountains, and coming home at night, we'll get a little jingle on our heart and sing, you know. And he's doing, you're doing much better. I'm so proud of you.
Well, thank you. Thank you.
I am. Yes, we've been praying for that, but I love to sing. I wake up singing
that way,
sometimes.
You said you've really been praying for that, like I really need it bad.
Well, it's
right?
It's good to have somebody, you know, to sing with.
I know. I make a joyful noise.
You're a great cook, too.
Well, okay, thank you.
You are. You're a great cook. No, but we do. We have a good time, and we do like to sing, and sometimes we'll put on some of the old songs and the Goodmans and some of those. We love to be in an atmosphere of worship, whatever we're doing.
And you know, song, his word coming forth in song, that brings him on the scene even more so. The word says he inhabits the praises of his people.
That's right.
And so if you've got a song in your heart and you're pouring that out to him, he loves it. He desires it, Gwen.
Yeah. And you're like the rest of us. We haven't been out very much since March, you know, to the grocery store, maybe to the drugstore, very little. But you can also set an atmosphere waiting in your home.
That's right.
You know, if it's just singing, walking, we've got a great place where we walk. And not long ago, we have Duchess. I guess she's around 16, 17 now. And I was walking her the other morning, me and her just praying. We walk and I sing, and she just goes right along. I don't know if I walk her or if she walks me. But I had this little song on my heart, and I was just singing along. So we started back into where we live, and this gentleman on the floor up said, "I'm Georgia singing." I said, "Well, thank you." That early in the morning, I didn't think there'd be anybody else at that time. But you know what? He said, "Make a joyful noise."
That's it.
And to the Lord. And mine is with song. I love to sing to him. If it's on the bed, if it's in the kitchen where I'm at, I love to do it. The Shireys are going to be doing some music with us tonight, and Victoria Bolin. And I selected some songs that I thought would be very special. Wade's going to tell a little story here in a minute, but Sandy Knight wrote this song, and I know it's going to minister to you tonight. It's called Little David.
Whatever you're fighting tonight, whatever you're going through, just remember that Jesus loves you, and he cares what's going on in your life. Well, little David, oh, so small. Goliath was oh, so tall. Odds were just too high for poor little David. But he shook off all of his load. For with the power of God he was clothed. Said, "The battle's not mine, I give it all to you. Lord, it's thine." No, the battle's not mine, said the little David. "Lord, it's thine, I'm in your favor. I've given it all to you. For I knew not what to do, but I'm so glad you let me see. You're really all that I need. Though the battle's not mine, I give it to you. Lord, it's thine."
Now little David unafraid before that giant stood that day, and it seemed to be the end for poor little David.
Poor little David.
Just like the lion and the bear he slew, you see, Goliath would come down too. "Oh, the battle's not mine, I give it all to you. Lord, it's thine." Well, now little David, he stood tall. You see, Goliath was made so small. How sweet victory had reigned
for poor little David.
And you know why? 'Cause he gave that battle to one that had a record of getting things done. Said, "The battle's not mine, I give it all to you. Lord, it's thine." No, the battle's not mine,
said a little David. "Lord, it's thine, I'm in your favor. I've given it all to you. For I do not what to do, but I'm so glad you've let me see.
I know
you're really all that I need. Though the battle's not mine, I give it to you. Lord, it's thine."
Now's a good time for you to slip your hand up and give God praise. I don't care what you're going through tonight. Nothing is too hard for God. Is that right, Wade?
That's it, exactly. And you mentioned earlier that song. Roy and Sandy will never know what that meant for me at a point in time in my life. I was really down, and I'd been just moping around for days. And the Lord gave me three songs on my heart that just kept coming to me, and one of them was Little David. I found it, I put it on a tape, and then my job then, I'd be on the road up to 2-3 hours a day many times, and what I did is I put that in and I played that song over and over. And the Lord spoke to me over and over again, telling me that the battle I was in, it wasn't mine, it was His. And it was because of that song, that word coming forth in song, that changed my life around at that point in time, Gwen. It meant so much to me. Mm-hmm. And that's why God's word is so powerful and so fulfilling in our lives. Our scripture tonight comes out of Mark 16 and 15, and it reads like this. And He said unto them, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. Now, you know, when He says, go into all the world, you start thinking, well, there's missionaries, there's preachers, there's teachers, there's all these people out here to go around and preach the gospel around the world. But you want to know something? Every one of us are ministers unto the gospel.
That's right.
We all have a work to do.
That's right.
God's given each and every one of us something to do. It may be that it's, maybe you're shut in some, but you got a telephone. I don't know anybody today that doesn't have telephones. I see little kids that just barely can hold them using a phone. But I'll tell you what, get on the phone, call someone. God will lay people on your heart and encourage them, or give them a scripture, or whatever. And God's word in song. Maybe you can sing, unlike me, but maybe you can sing. You could sing a little song to somebody that would lift them up, or just a word of encouragement and all. Well, you say, well, I can't go into all the world. Guess what? I saw something came to me about a TV program on a news broadcast, and I think it's called Waters World, Jesse Waters. And on that program, there's a segment of it, he'll say, this is, you know, my world. This is Waters World. I'm Jesse Waters, and this is my world. Why don't you say, I'm Wade Hall, or I'm Gwen Hall, or whoever you are, this is my world here around me, and I'm going to share the gospel.
Yeah.
I'm going to bring it to someone that needs the word.
Really,
we have a dying world out here in so many ways that we need to uplift the people and show them God's word. They need to know that there is a Savior. They need to know that there is a provider. They need to know there is a healer.
Yes.
They need to know that there's Jehovah Jireh, our provider, and no matter what we need, He is. So I'm telling you tonight, take your world that you're in, share the gospel to someone. Well, you may do it over the phone. You may go into a store, you see someone, give them a smile. If they look down, look at them and say, well, you know, do you know Jesus? It's amazing how you can get a conversation started. Gwen used to say, I can walk up and talk to anything or anybody. But I'll tell you, it's all about the Lord, our lives.
Amen.
If it wasn't for Him, we wouldn't be here.
Mm-hmm.
So we should be sharing the good news of the gospel. Gwen, it's so important to put that word out there, mm-hmm. because there is people that need to hear what God can do.
And Sam's, that day you walked in, and that girl, she didn't have to tell them quickly.
Gwen and I were going into Sam's one day, and they were checking your card as you come through the door, and this young lady was standing there, and she looked. We held the card up, and I said, "You know, hey, how are you?" And she said, "I'm okay," but she did it in a way that something wasn't right. So I looked there and I said, "Okay, what's the matter?" And she looked at me and she said, "Well, I don't feel good. What's wrong?" She said, "I've had a horrible headache all day." And I just looked at the young lady and I said, "That headache's got to go in Jesus' name." Yeah. And I just turned and walked away. There were other people coming through the door. But you know, just saying those few words meant all the difference to her at that moment in time, because she was watching for Gwen and I to come around the other side, leaving the store. And she came up and she said to me, she said, "Excuse me," but said, "You know," and this is the way she put it, "You know those words you said to me? My headache is gone."
Oh,
that's all it took.
Yeah.
That's all it took. There's power, Gwen, in His Word.
Yes.
And you know, His Word doesn't return void.
That's right.
It accomplishes that which it is intended to do.
And we always pray, "Lord, help us to be in the right place at the right time."
That's right.
It never fails when we leave the house, if we're wherever we're going, we have an opportunity, it seems like always, to minister to somebody, to tell somebody about Jesus. That's what, you know, a lot of us haven't been able to go to church. Why hadn't we not gone to church? But when we're out and about and we can go to a drugstore or a grocery store, we do take that opportunity.
That's right.
To tell somebody about Jesus.
That's it.
Amen. I'm telling you right now, we've got a big program tonight. I'm telling you, Crossfire is here. Randy Shepherd, Jamie Johnson, they're going to come over and share here in a little while. When you about preached tonight, I was about to be in the amen corner over here.
Oh.
We're going back now to Victoria Bowen. She's going to do a song that I love so much. She wrote, "Still Faithful."
Serve a faithful God who is willing and more than able to take care of every need that you may have tonight.
If I have to bear this pain and walk out in the rain to be important to me, I'll let it
nothing to see, and I just have to believe, Lord, that you are working behind the scenes. Lord, you're still faithful, still faithful to me.
He's a faithful God. What is it that you need tonight? He's able to do abundantly above all that you could ever ask or think. If it's healing, if it's your marriage needs a healing, maybe it's your children, maybe some of them are on drugs, whatever it is, it's not too hard for God. He said in Jeremiah, is there anything too hard for me? And there's not. All things, that's what he said in his word, all things are possible. All things are possible with God. So whatever it is, tonight, we have prayer partners here live. The number's on the bottom of your screen, 244-1616. We would love to hear from you and pray over your requests. Roy and I, we are praying and believing God for your miracle in Jesus' name. There's many out there that are standing and believing for miracles, and we are standing with them in Jesus' name. They're here tonight. If you've got a praise report, maybe God has blessed you. Maybe you've got a breakthrough in your finance. Come on. Some of you have been without jobs, and some of you hadn't had the money to pay your light bill. Maybe somebody just blessed you and you were able to do that. You need to give God the glory, not man. God gets all the glory and the praise for what's done in your life, in Jesus' name. It's my very special pleasure tonight to have two wonderful people here with me that I think they're at the top of my list of how I feel about them. 30 years of ministry this year. Come on. Crossfire Ministries. Randy Shepherd, Jamie Johnson. We love you. You know, thank God for your ministry. 30 years. I cannot believe that. I remember Jonathan's 30, but he was just young when the two of y'all said, oh, let us take and keep him overnight. He was just like this tall, and I was like, no, I don't think so. Oh, he'll be fine. We'll watch him. That's been many years ago. Look how that ministry has grown. Would you have ever thought, Jamie, would you have thought it would have grown that much?
It's been amazing to be with Randy, travel the world, 68 countries, 45 states, and take little John and all these kids who've come over the years. We've been blessed to see what God's done.
And our grandkids came. They loved it. Yes. Now our grandkids are coming. That makes me feel a little older, although we have 20 of them right now. But you know what? God has certainly blessed you, and it's a gift that you have. Use that basketball. You know, I've got a video. We're going to show their ministry in a minute. But for the parents, you've got to get the kids in front of the TV, because I know they're going to go to bed here in just a few minutes. It's 8:30. Randy, I want you to take that ball, and I want you just to share, especially with these young people. I see all these kids are in. They can't get to go out and do anything. But you're going to enjoy. Hey, I'm going to give you a minute to get the kids around the TV, because you don't want them to miss what they do with this ball. Amen. Look at that.
Well, it's
camera.
A blessing and a privilege to be here. Jamie and I played against each other in middle school, high school, and college. And I tell folks when I introduce Jamie, I got the greatest ministry partner in the world.
You do.
We've taught each other different things, and most co-founders don't last 30 years together. So thank God for God's mercy and grace and Jamie's mercy and grace. When I was a little guy, I couldn't jump like Jamie. I wasn't as quick as he was, but I was told if I could handle this basketball, there would be a place for me on the team. So from a very young age, I would do different ball handling drills in the kitchen floor every night. And then I saw this at a Wake Forest basketball camp when I was 9 years old, a guy that was called Crazy George, and he was spinning the ball. So I came home and decided I wanted to try it. So came home and we put the ball on different fingers, and kids asked today, hey, how do you do that? Well, you do it about 100 times, and one day it sticks on your finger. And then I've got Jamie praying for me. Next day, Mom and Dad came home. I had a spoon out. And when Jamie and I in Crossfire get to travel around the world, 68 countries and 46 states, Africa, Russia, Cuba, the Ukraine, Argentina, Brazil, and TV16 is one of our favorite places. We tell folks this is how boys from Asheville eat ice cream. Not all, but a few. You get it going real good. And you eat your ice cream like so, but the message behind it is taste and see that the Lord is good. How do you taste the Lord? You repent of your sin. You give your life to Jesus, find out how much He loves you, how much He cares for you. The next day, Mom and Dad came home. I had a toothbrush out. And just like this silly toothbrush is going to clean my teeth, Jamie and I have been blessed to go to Israel 23 times. And we tell young people and adults, you can believe the book is the Word of God. You can believe the maps too. Wow. And there's a place there called Golgotha. And at Golgotha, a holy God, John 1:1 said, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. In a sinful world, for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life. But we have a problem. And Jamie does an awesome job of sharing how his dad led him to the Lord as a young boy. But Jesus went to the cross. Mm-hmm. He bridged the gap.
That's right.
For my sin, for your sin, for Jamie's sin, for your sin that's watching. And He paid the penalty. And He didn't stay in the grave like Buddha, Muhammad, Confucius, all the religious leaders you're going to learn about. But on the third day, Jesus came out of the grave because He was God. And just like this silly toothbrush is going to clean my teeth, Jesus Christ wants to clean our hearts up.
Amen.
And give us peace and hope and purpose for living. Then when you get excited about the Lord, like Brother Wade was preaching a few minutes ago, and he was encouraging us as evangelists. I was fired up from hearing him. This is an old school cell phone. You young people out there don't know what this is, but it's a flip phone. Now we can do it on an iPhone, but they're way too expensive. And God called Jamie and I to start this ministry, to go into all the world and preach the gospel.
That's right.
You may be a plumber, you may be an electrician, you may be a housewife, you may be a doctor. God wants you to use your talents and abilities to share with others, to lead others to Christ. Glory to God.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Randy, what if someone's watching right now and they say, you know, I want to know more about this Jesus. I'd like for Him to come in my heart. How would you share that tonight?
I'm going to pass an assist to Jamie. He's got a great story about his dad leading to the Lord.
Jamie, will you share
Share that with him, Jamie, and then close with the gospel, brother?
Sure. Thank you, Gwen. Thank you, Randy and Wade, what he shared earlier about Mark 16:15. Jesus said, go into all the world and preach the gospel to the whole creation. And Randy and I get to do that. You just saw him spin a ball. And maybe that's not your talent, your ability, but somewhere we pray you hear about Christ. And tonight you're watching TV and you're going to hear it right here. Randy just gave a great illustration of the gospel. And when I was younger, I was the religious kid. I went to church, had a God-fearing preaching dad, minister of music mom, grateful for my heritage, two godly sisters, Rebecca and Karen, love the home life. But at some point, I had to go from being religious to a relationship. That means understanding with my heart that Jesus Christ died for my sins, for your sins. So maybe you're watching tonight, you're not sure of your salvation. You're not sure if you died, and God said, why shall I let you to heaven? What to say to Him? Well, the Bible gives an answer. The Bible says in John 3:16, for God so loved the world that He sent His only begotten Son, that whomsoever believeth in Him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Now listen carefully. We've broken the law of God. The Bible says so. If you break one law, you've broken all the laws. That means we're rebellious. Even sometimes the religious kid, we can be rebellious. And how did I go from religion to relationship? Well, I got in trouble. And I heard that this gospel was real from my father one more time. I heard it on Sunday in church, but I heard it in a bedroom. I heard it more than once from my dad and my mom, but it took that particular day. I got in trouble, broke a window, lied about it, got in trouble, neighbor sent me home. Dad says, son, where you been? I told him I'd been down the street, broke a window. I told a lie. Well, son, today you need discipline. So I'm sitting on that bed with a belt that he asked me to grab. And he said, son, because I love you, I'm gonna do something very unique for you today. He said, I'm gonna take your whipping. I'm gonna take off my shirt. I'm gonna bend down over the bed. With my bare back, I want you to whip me on the back till I say stop. What he was showing me was what Christ did on the cross of Calvary. Jesus said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father but through me. And so Dad was showing me an illustration demonstrating the love of Christ by saying, I'll take off my shirt, I'll take your whipping. Son, I didn't tell the lie, but I'll take your punishment. You see, folks, men and women, boys and girls, listen carefully. You don't put your eyes on Christians, we will fail you. You'll fail us. You put your eyes on Jesus, who was perfect, the living Son of God, born of a virgin. And when Jesus said, I'll die for your sins, he meant that. You don't want to die for your sins. You don't want to be separated and go to hell. You want to know Christ personally and have a relationship. You must confess him with your heart and life. And I'm sitting in that room thinking, whip my dad? No, I told the lie. I deserve the whipping. I dropped the belt. I said, Dad, I finally understand. I finally understand, age 9, what happened at the cross of Calvary when Jesus laid down his life and then he rose from the grave. I want that relationship with him. I want to put my faith in him. And I believe he died for me. And right there, I said a prayer. Not at church. You can do it at church. Not in a Bible study class. You can do it there. But outside church walls, in a bedroom. I just got in trouble. Total lie. Was called. I said yes to Christ. And when I prayed that prayer of repentance and believed on him, I did what the Bible says. You shall be born again. That's what Jesus said to a religious man. You must be born again to inherit heaven. And I put my faith in Christ. If you're watching tonight and you've listened to Gwen and Wade over and over on these programs, maybe this is your night of salvation. Maybe you need to say a prayer of salvation and repent of sin. Romans 10:9 says, and I'm finished, but if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord, believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. That is, born again. Become a child of God. Become a Christian. They all mean the same thing. And I want to lead you to prayer right now where you can put your faith in Christ, because you're watching. Somebody probably prayed you to this program and asked that you might watch tonight and see Randy spin a ball and Gwen sing so beautifully and Wade shares her earlier. This could be your day of salvation. Now listen carefully. There's no prayer in the Bible that says you got to pray a prayer of salvation. We use this as evangelists, that you can have a starting point right here where you can repent of sin and believe on Christ. And you can do that now with heads bowed and eyes closed. If you want to say a prayer and put your faith in Christ, don't say, I got to change my life first. Let Christ come in and change your life. And then God, by the power of the Holy Spirit, comes into your life and begins to change you day by day and bring you closer to him moment by moment. So if you want to trust in Christ, you pray this prayer with me. You can pray it out loud. You can pray it silently. But God knows the attitude of your heart. And if you want to pray this prayer of salvation, repenting of sin, and believing on Christ who died for you, pray this in your heart as I pray it out loud. Father in heaven, I understand tonight I'm just like Jamie and Randy. I understand I'm a sinner. I'm separated from you. I'm lost in sin. And I'm not pleased with that. And so tonight, I'm doing what the Bible says, your word. I'm confessing sin and repenting. And I'm asking for your forgiveness. And I believe with my heart, all that I am, that you, Jesus Christ, the perfect Son of God, died for me. I believe with my heart that you died for me, for all of my sins. I believe you rose from the grave. And I believe one day you're coming again. Lord Jesus, save me. Come into my heart and life and help me to live for you. I'm following you tonight. Thank you, Jesus, for dying for my sins. Thank you for dying for me. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. If that's you tonight and you prayed that with Jamie, Randy, myself, will you pick up the phone right now? The number's on your screen. Call them, tell the prayer partners what's happened. Let them know that you've just given your heart to the Lord. Jamie and Randy, I've been knowing them for many, many years. They have a huge ministry. What started small as a seed has now is just like a, this huge, beautiful tree. We have a video I'm going to show right now of their ministry. It would take us all night long to just break down everything. But they so beautifully have put this together in a video that I know is going to bless you tonight. Again, the number's there on your screen. We'd love to hear from you. Wade will be doing a phone report in just a few moments, and I would love to hear that you gave your heart to Jesus, for you see, He's coming soon. Mm-hmm. Just any day, He's coming, and I want you to be ready. Amen? Mm-hmm. I want you to be ready. So if you would go to your phones right now, call, let the prayer partners pray with you. They've got a little book that Jimmy and Joanne wrote. It was here in this little drawer. I don't see it right now right off the bat. But you know what? It's a precious little book.
It's on the screen.
And we'll send it to you. First Steps. It's a handbook for new and growing Christians. So we'd love to send that to you tonight in Jesus' name. All right, let's go to that video.
We're turning over every stone, hoping to find salvation in a world that's left us cold. Can we get back to the altar, back to the arms of our first love? There's only one way to the Father, and He's calling out to us. To the captive, it looks like freedom. To the orphan, it feels like home. To the skeptic, it might sound the power of the cross. So can we get back to the altar, back to the arms of our first love? There's only one way to the Father, and He's calling out to us. To the captive, it looks like freedom. To the orphan, it feels like home. To the skeptic, it might sound crazy.
When I know I deserve the fall, it called me out of my darkness and carried me to the cross. In a moment, my eyes were open. In that moment, my heart was changed. Like a blinding light in the dead of night, it's the gospel. Oh, to the captive, it looks like freedom. To the orphan, it feels like home. Yeah, to the skeptic.
We just need to slip our hands up.
Amen.
And give God thanks for all those many, many souls. I don't know if I have enough on here. Over 22,000 young people have attended in 25 years. Over 14,000 decisions for Christ. I don't even think that's more and more. And even this year, I even seen a golf tournament that Wade attended y'all have every year. That's one of his highlights of the year. Is to go and get to play golf with them. And Joni and Marcus, I know them. They've been in our home. What an opportunity that was to be on their TV program. They're just awesome people of God as well. Look at the many doors God has opened. How does all that just happen? I mean, do you make phone calls or people call you or they send you emails? Or that's a lot.
We do it all. We pray and then we call and just sent out a newsletter, social media, and just Jamie and I pray together, God, for open doors. One story I remember, we were driving early on when we just started to speak in a prison in the middle of North Carolina. We were listening to a message by Dr. Charles Stanley.
I love you.
The message was, open your mouth wide and God will fill it. And we come back to that many times, that too young, we didn't know much, but we had a desire to serve the Lord. We had some good mentors like Dr. Johnson, Adrian Rogers, Billy Klein, yourself. And we just went and tried to do what God's Word says, and God has blessed us far above what we could ever imagine, think, or say. Glory to God.
I remember hearing someone talk about when they got to heaven, they believed that, you know, or Billy Graham got to all the souls that he'd ever seen saved would be right there. Of course, I know he wanted to see Jesus. But you know what? I think you're going to have an opportunity as well when you get there. It's going to be something about what you did for the Lord. All those people come up. It was your ministry. It was that prayer you prayed. It was that prayer you prayed tonight on TV. God is awesome.
Amen.
He's an awesome God.
Amen.
And know tonight, if you prayed that prayer tonight with Jamie, we want to hear from you. Wade's joined us over here. We want to pray for you. We want to pray for your needs. We know we've been in since March like the rest of you. And we've tried to just stay connected in prayer, watch things that would minister to us. Sometimes we just turn on some gospel music, worship music. And I even seen that you had a small camp this summer.
Yeah.
Well,
we weren't going to let them shut us down if we couldn't. We were able to have 2 weeks, and we had about 95 campers and 37 professions of faith. And nobody got sick, praise the Lord.
Thank you, Lord,
for
that.
That's right.
But you know, that was a step of faith. Sometimes things are a step of faith, right, Wade?
They are.
Glory to God, I'm telling you. And tell me, did they minister like that when you went to the golf?
Oh, yes. That's one thing I love about it. Before the tournament gets underway, as far as playing the golf, they bring the word. You know, and they do. And then, you know, it's wonderful to be able to start a tournament like that. It's not about the golf. It's about the relationship of the people with the Lord.
Amen.
And that's what they put
first. And the fellowship.
That's it. And that's what they put first. And
praise
I like
God.
That.
Praise God. You've joined us. Do I see a praise report?
You've got several here. Here's Melanie Colleen had a great report from the doctor.
Amen.
When the blood work came back. Lady had a blood test and an echocardiogram for cause of blood clots. But when the test came back, everything was normal.
Amen.
Here's someone that they're praising God that there's no blocked arteries and the heart murmur is gone in Jesus' name.
Thank you, Jesus. Amen.
And want us to remember two family members that are fighting the COVID virus right now. And here's one that said, prayed for a grandson for 29 years. Had cancer, but has now been cancer-free for 5 years.
Give God praise.
Amen. Praise Amen. God,
God
for
praise.
That.
You know, we only have less than a minute, but there are a lot of prayers that are coming in, and we're going to pray over every one of them tonight. My brother-in-law is at home. He's been in the hospital, but thank God he's doing some better. I tell him he's my favorite brother-in-law. He's my only brother-in-law. But we're thinking about you tonight. I'm glad you're doing better. Thank you, Jesus. And this first hour has just come. I cannot believe an hour has already gone by. We've worshiped with you. We've prayed with you. We want to hear some more good praise reports. God is moving and blessing. If you can't get through, you just keep dialing that number. Somebody will pick up where you can tell them what the Lord has done for you. We'll be right back